Well, ladies and gentlemen, you're about to see a world-class carver. I'm Scott Phillips, and...
My name is Reto Odermatt. I'm a master woodcarver from Switzerland.
Now, he was trained in Brienz, and you're about to learn some of the most unique ways to use Swiss-made or file chisels that are made in Switzerland. Now, you were talking about using one chisel as three or four by using different profiles. Could you demonstrate that for us, please?
Yes. You can use one and different sizes. You can use the hole, sharpen it for to cut.
And you notice how he likes to roll that with his drive hand as he makes that cut to shear the fibers.
You can drive it, you can cut the whole size, or you can cut in one each
right
to the other one, and you can, it's very nice cutting.
He's using basswood on this.
This is basswood, yes.
Right. And that's his favorite wood. Mm-hmm. Now, in your carving studio, how many chisels, Swiss made, do you have?
I have around 120 different chisels and knives.
Okay, now if you get three or four different profiles out of that, then that means you get about, 600 different, 600 to 800
yes.
different types of cuts here. Now, when you're working on a bear like this, tell us about how you approach your work and rough it in and then do the detailing.
Yes. For the first steps, I need big chisels like this one. A big chisel I can use in many ways, where we talked before. I have a flat size or a circular size. Then I can go to circle it like this here and do flat like this here. This is what I use in the first steps. I do the rawest stuff with big chisels.
Now, one interesting thing, your grandmother made these for you, and you've never had problems with carpal tunnel, and that keeps the blood circulation going there?
Yes, it has to be very warm, thus you have warm spoons for your hands, because it's dangerous when you work in cold places outside with chainsaw or big chisels, the vibration for the hammer, it's not that good.
Right.
For your spoons.
That's brilliant. That's a tip worth doing. Okay, now let's see some more cuts here. Teach us some techniques.
Okay, I cut it all over this bear. You see the different.
That is like a hot knife through butter. And you'll learn how to sharpen chisels in another segment, the easiest way. Doesn't matter what the profile is, but I really love the way you're using your body. I mean, that's the thing.
Yes.
It's not.
They give
arm,
a little bit pressure.
Yeah.
And you can give with the body pressure, much more pressure.
Now, when you do a bear carving like this, how long would it take for you to complete a?
From the start to the finish.
Yeah.
The start is the model is carved first with a pantograph.
Right.
And from the finished pantograph to finish bear, it takes about 2.5 days.
That's flying. Not that fast. I'm not in your class, but I do love to carve. Now, on something like this, which is a commission piece that you're making models of, how much time would you have in this?
This from the whole block to the finish to paint, it takes about four, six days.
That is beautiful. That's a different wood. That's not basswood. What is this?
Yes, it's the same wood.
Really?
But it's growing up in another place, and one piece grows up in the forest, the other one on a landscape. It's very different.
That's the most dense
this
European
is,
basswood I've ever seen.
This is a hard piece one, yes.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Beautiful. Well, let's see some more detailing.
Yes. For the details, we use the smaller tools. I go here to the eyes.
I like the way you make bold strokes. These aren't tentative little nibbling cuts. You move a lot of material there.
It's important that you cut the wood and don't push. That's important. When you have a very good knife, like Pfeil tool is very good. It's in the steel, it's not too soft and not too hard. And you can use it in many different wood. Not only in soft wood like this, you can use it also in hard wood too.
Okay.
And I've to do the finish, I changed the tools many times. That's the reason why we have there many tools. We told at the school or for my friends, wood carving friends, for every cut the right knife.
Right. How long did you study at Brienz?
4 years. It's apprenticeship about 4 years.
Was there one master carver that you worked with more than any other?
They are limited about to study because there are not enough space for to learn. You have to do first a test that you can go to the school. They test you about drawing and modeling and wood carving, and after they tell you are good, you can go to study this.
Well, also a part of that test, because I've talked to a few people that have trained there, you also have to be fast, because ultimately they say you have to be productive, and if it takes you too long to carve a piece, well, you wouldn't be able to make a living at it.
Yes, it's when you have too long, the piece is too expensive for.
Right, exactly. Well, we'll let you do a few more cuts here. Just let you work away. On a carving like this, what's the most important piece of the carving that really you focus on to really make it come to life?
It's important that you work always on the whole piece. Don't work on one each and do it finished and after the other one. It's very important that you work everywhere. Do first the big steps from the whole piece and after go more to the detail.
Okay.
That's very important. Don't do first the head and after the other stuff. Go from outside, we talk about from outside to inside.
In order to keep it balanced.
Yes.
Proportionate. I like the way the muscles on this bear are just tense. It makes it feel like it's alive. Beautiful work. Now, when this is done, what finish will you put on this?
The finish is like a color, brown color, and after a wax, a brown antique wax.
Okay, and are these all Brienz products or?
No, all over the world.
All over the world, okay, good. Well, that's the story on Brienz and Reto and how he approaches this work. Now let's go over and set up to show sharpening tips.
Yes, sure.
Okay.